Hey, welcome back. It's time for another Trueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. We'll be joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun and our annual Excel is Funner. This time we're talking about VLOOKUP. This is episode 113.
So, this is VLOOKUP. And you see these names and bikes? We want them to appear like there's like going to be a drop down. And then there's going to be a bike right there, whatever name I put. So you see those, you go to this, and then where are you? There. Then you know any value you want, list, and then we can do this for faster if you know this. Oh, right. You do that, and then we get that, and then you do okay, and then you see there's a drop down, and then after the drop down, you can do Isaac, Brandon, or Larissa, pop up name, Brandon, Larissa. Okay, so then you get. You do this. You go equals V. And if you look closely, you'll see the V lookup. And then. Wait. What was that? Right. So we do that. And then.
What is that? Is that. How? What is the V lookup? Like what does the VLOOKUP do with that?
It turns it into like this blue D2. And then it's like blue surrounding. So that's why it's blue. And then you do. And then you do those. With that. And then. And then you press 2, because the bike is in 2. And then you press enter, and then it does that. Then you can do that, and then you can do that, and then you can do that. Okay,
that's
now I'm
going
to throw it over to Mr. Excel. That was pretty quick. That was a snapshot.
All right, Isaac, that was a great trick doing a VLOOKUP. At what, age six? That's amazing. All right, so how am I going to improve on that? That's incredible. I'm going to do Alt-DL to create the data validation, allow a list, and the source will be just like Isaac did there, A2 to A4. But I'm going to add an input message that says, hey, select from the list. Please choose from the list. All right, so, hey, so see that? Now when I select that cell, it tells them what to do, just in case they don't know anything about computers and they don't have any clue what to do. So now they can choose from the list. All right, then, equal VLOOKUP. So we're going to talk about different ways to enter form this. Isaac used the mouse a lot, but I'm going to use the arrow key. So I'm going to press the left arrow key, see which moves the blue dancing marching ants around D2. I'll press comma, and then over here, F4, even though we're not going to copy it, someday we might. Comma 2, and then at the end of every single VLOOKUP, you should always put false. Now, hey, we lucked out because this happened to be sorted, and so the true was able to work, but most of the time we want to put false. Just as you go through life, Isaac, say, if I'm doing a VLOOKUP, I want to end it in false or zero. There we go, and let's do a little test here. We'll choose Braden and then Larissa.
It's Brandon.
Is it Brandon? Then
yeah.
It's spelled wrong. And see, this will work even if the lookup list is sorted descending. It'll still continue to work with the comma false there.
What happens if you change the dad who misspelled Brandon? It should be an N. What happens if you change the N?
Well, then we're going to get an NA error right here. So if we would choose, if we had Braden there. Well, let's break it.
Well,
this is
There is a kid that I know named Braden.
Oh, the horrible NA-er. That's like the worst evil monster when you're doing VLOOKUPs, getting NA-ers. All right. Excel is fun.
Woohoo! Oh, an NA. Well, you know, if we were back in 2003, what would we have to do? We'd have to put the VLOOKUP two times. But I think we can just use this great new function, IFERROR. And then if it sees an error, it's just sitting in that value argument there. It's either doing the VLOOKUP or giving you an error, comma, and then value if error. Hey, I'm going to put something like double quote, null text string to show nothing. Or you could type, let's just see what that looks like. Or you could type a polite message, something like, try again. So now let's try again. We'll select, it broke the data validation. It actually pasted this on top, so you'd have to redo it. Hey, let's go over here. Let's look at a trick, Alt-DL. And I'm going to go ahead and select the list just like Isaac did right here. Click OK. So now I have my drop down, right? And then you can do your VLOOKUP, arrow key, comma. And I'm going to keep it sorted, right? I'm going to just put a 2 here for the second column. But watch this. What if we wanted to add some names here? Notice that the data validation is it's got three names. If we convert this to a table, Control T, click OK. Now this is a table, so if I come to the end and tab, I can type Timmy. And Timmy doesn't have a bike. No bike. Is that right, Isaac?
Yeah.
And I'm going to put a not happy Smith face, because we need to get him a bike. Now, the thing is, we did data validation before we converted it to a table. So is it going to be there if I click this? And there it is. Look at, there's Timmy with, he doesn't have a bike. So even the table feature's got those dynamic ranges. But even if you have a range that's not what's there before you convert it to a table, it will still work. All right, I'm going to throw it back over to Isaac. You got to say,
see you next time.
Close it up. You got to say bye to everyone.
Bye.
How about next time? Are we going to do another Truel sometime?
Yes, sure. Whoa. I can even figure out how to stand on the computer.
All right, say bye.
Bye.
See you.